esteemed, friends and delegates, it's my proud privilege to share my knowledge on this very important topic, which is metabolism, insulin sensitivity, and physical fitness of human skeletal muscle with aging. Like it is really very important, and the talk of the day. We are growing old, and there are changes happening in our body because of the age itself. Like organs are growing also old, one. And secondly, because of the age, there are certain metabolic changes also occurring. Say, loss of lean body mass, as well as accumulation of fat, and, mitochondrial dysfunction, etc. So there are, numerous changes which are happening in our body because of aging. So this is an important thing, and let's see, how things are changing. So overall, if we see the world population, it's growing, the aging population, older population is growing at an enormous rate. And it is not only, our organs are dysfunctioning, even our physical limitations are there, changes in the bones and say movement and osteoporosis, risk of falls, overall poor quality of life and hospitalization and expenses because of hospitalization and other conditions. Overall, in Western countries, more than 55 years, almost 30% of the population, they're still facing physical limitation. And one of these physical limitation is our loss of, muscle mass as well as skeletal. So can we do something for this? Let's see, So first, let's see what is the etiology and pathophysiology behind this. So there are multiple, multifactorial, changes, determinants of elderly skeletal performance, like lifestyle factors are there. We are slowly, we become less active. Then biological factors are also there, and psychological factors are also. Like, there is a feeling of loneliness and, less social life. And these changes ultimately, they lead to changes in the muscular system, nervous system, and skeletal system. And ultimately, we see this is a young adult, this is the muscle mass. So there is a decrease in the number of fibers, as well as there is a decrease in the mass, the area of fibers. And this is not because of the aging itself, it is because of even anabolic resistance, like the growth of muscle. Like even if we take the same amount of protein, it may not get converted into the same amount of muscle mass as it is in the adult population or young people. Now, there are a number of other things, which are very important as we grow old, like muscle mass decrease with aging, one. But as I told you, obesity also is an important thing. We all develop. I've seen many people, as we grow old, even we are thin, even otherwise Indian phenotype is like that. But with aging, it gets precipitated and there's more of central obesity and maybe overall. So fat mass increases and physical activity, if they improve, then definitely muscle mass will improve. But because of the age and obesity, muscle mass will go down. Muscle strength also similarly with age and obesity will go down. So physical activity, we see, is helpful in tackling all these muscle mass, strength, insulin sensitivity, mitochondrial capacity, which generally go down as we grow old. One is because of aging and then other metabolic changes. So basically, we have only say physical activity as a tool to combat for this problem and maybe, increase quality, say class one proteins. So these two things are very important. Now, if we see the muscle metabolism, like muscles also secrete like adipocytes secrete adipocytokines. So muscles also secrete myokines, and these myokines have autocrine, paracrine, and endocrine effects. And these effects are on the neighboring tissues, on the skeletal muscles and other organs. So that's how the muscles also interact, like adipocytes interact with the rest of the body. Similarly, muscles also interact with the rest of the body. And these, slowly, muscles are very important in our glucose homeostasis. If we have a good muscle mass, there is an increased glucose uptake and there is a control of blood glucose. But definitely, if muscle mass goes down, there would be alteration in glucose homeostasis. And at the same time, there's insulin resistance, there would be precipitation of dysglycemia and diabetes. Now, aging of skeletal muscle, we see, is central in the pathogenesis of immune senescence and sarcopenia. Sarcopenia is again the talk of the day, and like as we grow old, there is less muscle mass and muscular strength. So aging, slowly there are changes in the immune cells, in the body compositions, and more of, inflammatory cytokines also get released, IL-6, and TNF alpha, IL beta, etc. So resilience is basically it's the capacity of the body to come back, to regenerate from a physiological or a pathological stress or injury. So whenever there's an injury, the body, you know, takes over and there is an improvement and a regeneration. But same, you know, is there in our body. So metabolic regeneration is one. If there's a metabolic stress with intake of food, can we combat with this? Or ultimately there's an insulin resistance and hyperglycemia. Similarly, muscles also, you know, if there's a physiological stress, can they regenerate? So slowly over time with aging, there's a denervation and renervation also going on in our body. So it depends, you know, whether denervation is faster or re-innervation is more, which will decide the fate of the muscles. So overall, muscle mass is regulated with muscle protein synthesis and muscle protein breakdown. Okay. So there has to be a balance between these two. If muscle protein synthesis is less and breakdown is more, then definitely there is going to be decreased muscle mass, which is there as we grow old. And also, you know, food intake and physical activity definitely goes down. So overall, basically, you know, all these anabolic effects of even amino acids, dietary proteins will be dependent on the resistance. So like we have insulin resistance, there's some kind of an anabolic resistance. Means whatever protein we take, it may not get converted into muscles and other, you know, good tissues which are important for the body. So metabolic resilience is one part, and then muscle resilience is a second part. So metabolic, basically, as we grow old, you know, like it has been seen that quadriceps muscle, there's a loss in the muscle cross-sectional area, and this is associated with decreased muscle mitochondrial production, the function in terms of ATP production. So basically, there is a muscle mitochondrial dysfunction as we grow old. And this mitochondrial dysfunction, you know, ultimately leads to a metabolic, say, resistance, and resilience goes down. So, you know, the power to come back or to make this metabolic resistance normal decreases. So overall, there is development of insulin resistance and there is possibility of future diabetes. That is why whenever we say as we grow old, there's increased chances of diabetes. So anabolic resistance is very important, like insulin resistance. And it has been seen in many studies that there is an inability to stimulate muscle protein synthesis and inhibit muscle protein breakdown. So basically, as we grow old, there is a less of stimulation of MPS and more of a breakdown. So that leads to decrease in muscle fibers and muscle mass. So this is an important thing. So ultimately, what is required is we have to improve the quality of proteins we take, essential amino acids and plant-based proteins, as well as muscular exercises. So, you know, these are important things, you know, like here we can see, you know, so overall, ultimately, there is ultimately insulin resistance, endothelium reticulum, stress and anabolic resistance. Now we can see here that anabolic resistance with aging, we can see here very clearly that adults, you know, there is loss of, if there is a loss of in myofibrillar muscles by 0.7, on the similar conditions, anabolic resistance will lead to a loss of 1.2 gram per kg. This is a muscular mass loss. So this is what is, you know, the anabolic resistance in an adult and in an older person. So there's more muscle loss with the same anabolic resistance in older people than young people. Now, anabolic resistance, we can see here, there's a decrease in muscle protein, you know, synthesis, and there's more of a breakdown. And the studies was done with heavy water, D2O. And it was seen that there was a decreased hypertrophic response, decreased rate of chronic muscle protein synthesis. So overall, multiple factors are there, decreased ribosomal biosynthesis, transitional efficiency, and decreased anabolic hormones. So there's so many things, you know, are happening simultaneously. Now, aging. So that was metabolism, one part. Now the second part is insulin sensitivity with aging. Now with increase, you know, like as we grow old, the many things come up, as we have already told you, mitochondrial dysfunction, increased inflammatory cytokines, inflammation leading to insulin resistance, And similarly, RAS system, renin angiotensin system, also gets stimulated, autophagy, sarcopenia. Ultimately, all this leads to insulin resistance, and this leads to some kind of a muscle deconditioning, and we are less active, and you know, it leads to increased insulin resistance and other features of decreased muscular strength and mass. There are other changes also happening in the body composition which affect this insulin sensitivity, and this is basically, there's an altered body composition, and like you would all agree with me, there's an increased abdominal and ectopic fat which increases as we grow old, and there's a decrease in muscle mass. So that's one point. But there is also, it has been seen again in studies, that intramyofibril or myocellular fibers fat. So increase intramyocellular lipid levels. This is another important thing. Inside the muscles also, there's an increase in triglycerides and other harmful lipids. So it is not only the central body, it is even inside the muscles. So basically, this aging and intramyocellular lipid accumulation, ectopic lipid accumulation, all this lead to insulin resistance. And this ultimately, there's a lipotoxicity, inflammation, insulin resistance, dysglycemia, and ultimately patient lands up with insulin resistance syndrome. Then mitochondrial dysfunction, we have already discussed. The only thing is, it is appears to be lipid-induced insulin resistance, and that also leads to mitochondrial. So basically, this lipid toxicity leads to mitochondrial dysfunction, and vice versa, this mitochondrial dysfunction leads to insulin resistance. And it has been seen that gastric bypass surgery, we have seen that there's a decrease in intramyo, cellular lipids, as well as there's improvement in mitochondrial dynamics, as well as improvement in insulin sensitivity. That is why we say there's a reversal or there's a remission of diabetes with gastric bypass surgery. Now, coming to skeletal muscles and aging and insulin resistance, so basically there's increased insulin resistance, mitochondrial dysfunction, inflammation, endoreticulum stress, leading to sarcopenia and overactivated renin angiotensin system. Everything is going parallel. Now, there's another aspect to it, that muscle GLUT4, we know blood glucose is taken up by muscles and through, GLUT4 receptors. So it has been seen that, there is decrease in insulin stimulated muscle GLUT4 content in patients who are old. So that means there's decrease in a short term, that decrease in GLUT4 receptors. And it has been seen by Cox et al. That exercise program increases these muscle GLUT4 receptors. So exercise remains the most important component of, to combat all these changes which are happening with aging. Now, there is also reduced muscle mass, decreased lower limb cross-sectional area, and also, basically overall there is increase in non-contractile structures. I mean, muscle is decreasing, but fats and other components are increasing. And it has been seen that there is, an older patient, there's increased intramyocellular quadriceps muscle, adipose tissue. So inside the, quadriceps, there's accumulation of fat by almost 1.7 times. And these people are unable to walk. Then there is almost after the age of 40, 8% loss of mass. Muscle mass every year, which is very significant. It starts at 40. See, try to understand. So at age of 40, I think we all should become conscious. And, slowly you can see this graph. There is a decrease in muscle mass over the years. And we can see, this is young 25 and this is at 63. See, there's a sparsity and there's a decrease. So this leads to, muscle strength as well as decreased glucose uptake. Also, there's a decrease in muscle fiber size. So there are fast switch type of fibers and they're slow, twitch type of fibers. So fast are type 2A and 2B, and there's more decrease in fast twitch muscle fibers than type 1. So basically type 2A and type 2B are more decreased than type 1. And type 2, since they're fast twitch, means there's inability to walk faster and run and, involved in other activities. We can see here, this is type 1 and 2A and 2B. So running and all this, they are very, very limited. only, you know, one can walk, but definitely if we continue to have an endurance and have the muscle mass preservation, like beta cell preservation, I think this would be the ultimately talk of the tomorrow. So this we have already discussed, and now overview of molecular and cellular changes. If we see that with old age, as I mentioned in in my previous in my introductory remarks, that there is a continuous denervation and re-innervation of the muscles going on as we grow old. But with the age, what happens? The re-innervation becomes less and there's more of denervation. So denervation becomes more than re-innervation, and that leads to decrease in the size of muscle fibers. And it has been seen that at the age of 60 years, studies have shown this, there is almost 25 to 50% less motor neurons versus 20 years of age. And there's loss of, you know, distal fast twitch motor neurons like muscle fibers, as we have already discussed. And, so which is more than the small fibers. And there is also, you know, changes in the contractile pattern of the muscles and metabolism. Like it has been seen in, you know, lateral vastus, you know, lateralis muscle, that, you know, these changes are happening. So that not only, you know, there's a decrease in the mass, there's a, even the functioning of the muscles also goes down. So this is a very clear, again, a depiction of, you know, as we grow old, that how, you know, there's a young adult, healthy adult, and we can see that there's a decrease in the fiber size, as well as the, you know, the number also goes down. And, you know, almost type 2, as I told you, are affected more than the type 1. Exercise is a potent counter, you know, a major. So, you know, that's that we all have to, because as we grow old, we are not in a mood to be active and to exercise, but on the contrary, it is the need of the hour today. So endurance exercises as well as resistance exercises, both are important to enhance the muscle insulin sensitivity, to improve mitochondrial respiratory capacity, as well as for the strength and power, it is resistance exercises. So both are equally important. And I think we should combine endurance with resistance exercises when we grow old. And I think it should start after 40 years and should be continued till you live. So, you know, takeaway messages are very clear. I think, you know, I have not taken much time. I've tried to be short. So because I could see Dr. Rakesh Sahai also on the screen. So world population is, aging rapidly world over. So is true for India. India, we already have, capital of diabetes and cardiovascular disease, hypertension, all insulin resistant states. So overall, when we grow old, there's more of insulin resistance. So like 30% of population already, you know, world over is getting affected. More so in India, being a developing country, more chances of, you know, development of diabetes and CVD. So we have to be more cautious. And not only CVD and diabetes, even history of falls, comorbid conditions, hospitalization, and premature deaths. Muscle, you know, also secrete myokines. We know mitochondrial dysfunction occurs, but all these can be improved with the help of exercise, like adipocytokines, inflammatory, and mitochondrial dysfunction improve after muscular, resistance as well as endurance exercises. So, and there is a decrease in lean mass, more of accumulation of fat, intramyocellular lipids, GLUT4 reduction, and ultimately decrease insulin sensitivity, more chances of development of all insulin resistant states, metabolism, decreased mitochondrial capacity, negative impact on resilience, like even muscle as well as metabolic resilience, both go down. And there's definitely a decrease in the muscle mass and more so of the fast twitch muscles than the slow type of muscles. So all these have an impact on our mobility, balance. There can be, you know, a history of falls and fractures. So with this, you know, I conclude and I convey my thanks to all of you, and I would be too happy.